yeah, cool.
Right, we currently are rolling, so anything you say can be taken in offence. Right, Mikey Gomez Jr., nice surprise today to bump into you. We were just saying out, every time, you know, you get a sort of a different gym, I'm there turning up, but I promise I'm not stalking you, mate. So you're looking
well,
good
it's hard when you've been to 99% of the gyms in the Northwest and I've been to...
I didn't want
to
say that, but yeah, you said
point, I've been in one of them.
Yeah, so you're here with Marvin Greaves.
Marvin and...
And Samson.
Samson,
yeah. Yeah. Good. Well, a great team because they're you know, they're the sort of guys that aren't going to mess around, you know, make sure you're in the gym, etc.
Well, they're straight and free that way.
I've heard they take their phones off you, is that right?
I don't have one anyway, I lost it. Nah, yeah, I think so, yeah. I don't bring mine to the gym anymore.
Fair enough. How are you doing, mate, just in general?
Sweet, getting back into it. I boxed, was it October? I can't remember when it was, October. And I ripped a muscle in my shoulder, so I had a break with that, and then my breaks, as you know, go from a break to a vacation.
Yeah.
And then I started ticking over, and then Friday I just came down here to meet manager Kev.
Yeah.
Did a session, and then things just happened from there, and now I'm here. It's Monday morning, I've just trained.
And you're here. Now, we haven't caught up since, we've had, I think, 3 fights since we've last caught up. Well, one of them was being your first professional defeat. Now I know you was very disappointed after that fight, you know, as that sort of, you know, just tell me a little bit about how that made you feel and, you know, looking forward now, you come off some solid wins now.
Boxing's a lot of bollocks, that's how it made me feel. That's as far as I'll go, like bollocks.
Tough rub on the decision and
next time you go to a boxing show, I shouldn't even say this because they've told me not, because they're getting, ask some of the officials. The referee that was meant to be scoring the fight in the ring didn't score the fight, the one judge outside. You know, over a 6-round fight, is that, you know, things like that don't happen. You know, just bollocks, but shit happens, doesn't it? You know what? I'm not glad it happened, but in a way, because I boxed them well, and to be honest with you, I probably got away with it, and I'd done it again. And the way I was feeling, if the kid had about half decent, I probably would have ended up in a bad way. Because never in my life have I been in a fight where after the first round I sat down and I actually thought I was like I couldn't. But when you're young and you're unbeaten and all, you think you can fight with everything, don't you? You know what I mean?
You've always had a touch of the maverick about you, like being a bit of a maverick.
Yeah, I thought I could get away with it. Well, I don't know, if I would have got away with it, and I probably would have gone into another, if it would have happened again and I got into a bigger fight, I probably could have ended up, you know, unboxing it. A joke, I seem to think it's funny, and you can get away with all sorts, but people are dying in the game left, right, and centre. It's no good.
Well, fair enough.
So one positive came out of it.
That you really have to take the game seriously.
Yeah. You can't box with illnesses and unfit and stuff, because it makes that. The feeling after that first round when I sat down was disgusting. I thought, bloody hell, this is no good.
You back out on the Frank Duffin show in May, is it?
No, March.
March, sorry, March.
4, 5, 3, 4 weeks or something like that.
And then potentially, I mean, we can't say nothing too much about it.
Boxing. There's a big fight. 14th of March. Cologne,
that's right. The Municipal Hall.
And then there's a show in Oldham on the 9th of May. I think it's a Black Flash one. I don't know if it's confirmed yet, but yeah, I'm going to be on that and then come through both of them. Wins, and then potentially there's a show in June where I could get my first title fight.
Okay, and we can't say anything at the minute just because we've got to cross the T's and dot the I's on that one.
Yeah, there's still, like, the show's got to be confirmed, but June should be having, hopefully. Everything being good, should be a first title fight.
You mentioned to me just then off camera that, you know, if nothing big happens in 2020, then you're gonna call it a day.
Yeah. I've been a pro. I think this is my 6th or 7th year or something daft as a pro. I think I've been pro far too long now. I should have been area level at least last year probably. You know, but there's loads of reasons, but most of them are my own, aren't they? You know, facts. And I've got to stay in the gym more. So this year, I'm paid by the end of June, I should have my first title, 3 fights this year, and then hopefully a few more before the end of the year. But let's, you know, if things don't keep kicking on, then I've just had enough of it. Yeah, I'll just gym it off.
What would you do if you weren't boxing?
Just be me anyway. It'd still be me.
But what would you do in terms of, like, you know, getting through and money wise and, you know?
Are you the police?
No, I'm just interested.
You got a warrant for that?
No, I'm just interested because I know, obviously,
there's a few, I'm interested in a few things, but I don't, well, box, I'm still going to box anyway, boxing, this is going to be a year where it's, I say it all the time, every time I meet you I say the same boring shit, might as well be a parrot, but this year, I do believe this year is going to be, well, I've got three things in line anyway, the only way they go wrong from here, the next three things is down to me, and then I can't blame anyone else or complain then. So
I've just heard you had a good reflective conversation there with Samson and talking about your natural talent and about how
attitude, my attitude.
I didn't obviously I was listening in a little bit, but I won't say
you listen to the lot.
That's what I was standing right next to you, to be fair. But it was good words.
Samson, I was there on Friday when I came. I only came down. It wasn't even. I was just come down more of just to. Well, manager was there, and within 10 minutes of in the door, he come here and made me sit down and have a chat with him. You know, he's that sort of person where he just gets straight to the point. And he says, you have got the ability to be at that level already, without even showing it. He says, but, you carry on the way you're going, moving around and messing up, you're just going to go down and down and down. That is true over the last 2 to 3 years. I can see myself, little things that have gone backwards. I have gone backwards, boxing-wise. Not massively, but there's a few things that I used to be able to do that I just can't do at the minute. Due to just not being in the gym, and he's saying, look, there's only you that can make things happen. He says, you've got the ability to go far, but keep fucking around, you ain't going nowhere, basically.
One thing I will say, I hope you feel like I can say this, because I've known you a few years now, and one thing I will say is, and all the trainers that have trained you, all the people around, even myself as well, I've spoke to you, everyone that's trained you, have always wanted the best for you. You know what I mean? I've always wanted the best for you in terms of...
Not everyone. Not everyone.
Well, all the ones I spoke to.
Yeah, but, I don't really give... One thing I can say is I don't give a fuck what anyone thinks or wants, I do what I do, and, that's probably my biggest problem, doing what I want to do all the time. Things have got to change, but the only person that can change them all in the end is me. But like I say, I'm 25 now. Boxing, the main thing can only go back to is, you never know when your boxing career is over. These fighters who are fresh, nothing wrong with them, and go in the ring and one shot game over, isn't it? You're done at.
Yeah.
Or you can go out tomorrow and anything could happen, injure it. So, I've just realised that this year I've just got to do what I've got to do and see what happens.
Do you watch boxing? Do you keep up with boxing? Not just in your division, but do you watch it?
I watch certain fights and certain things. I am boxing. I do like a lot. I do watch a lot of boxing, but not as much as most.
Who's your favourite boxer at the minute to watch? National scene, whatever.
I'm a Canelo fan. Yeah, probably Canelo,
There you go.
I'm a massive Carl Frampton fan though, I'm a massive Carl Frampton fan.
Well, you got a bit of the Irish in there, a bit of the Mexican in there.
Nah, I don't know, I've just always been a Carl Frampton fan, and the day he boxed, it was him, he was number one, and Leo Santa Cruz was number two at one point, but because of the way he's been not fighting anybody, Santa Cruz, I forgot about him. But yeah, when they boxed that time, that was pretty sick.
It's still time, Mikey, it's still time for you, mate, to have them big nights. You're not that old. How old are you?
Yeah, I'm only 25.
Maybe in the game still. Feels like we've been on a voyage.
Yeah, I've been a pro since I was about 17 and 18. Yeah, yeah. I have one fight a year, don't age.
There's still time.
But yeah, there's loads of time. I just, like I say, it's down to me and do what I want. To put my head down and graft, innit?
Sharp. Hey! Double jump.